Many moons have passed since I left the town of Tristram behind me. Since then, I've tried to forget the terrors I beheld beneath the cold earth and the twisted nightmares that have haunted my every waking moment. There's something dark within me now. I can feel it, driving me towards the east, assuring me that my salvation lies within the ruins of ancient kingdoms. Though I know the way, I know not what perils will arise to hinder my journey. And as I pass through the first gate, I know that the better part of my soul will remain behind. Forever.
So, Marius, at last I find you.
Tyrael, yes. Yes, now I recognize you. I should have known you'd travel in disguise. They're always watching.
I've been searching for you for a long time, Marius. I was rather beginning to think you didn't want to be found.
Oh, forgive me, Tyrael, please. It wasn't my fault.
Not your fault? Tell me, Marius, how was it not your fault?
The Wanderer. Yes, it was... the Wanderer. My days at the Rogue Citadel seemed so long ago. I sought refuge from my memories in the company of other outcasts high in the mountains past the Eastern Gate.
Do you want something?
Oh, I fought sleep for days at a time. For when I dreamt, the memories would return. Memories of the monastery and the evil which had claimed it. Dreams, memories. I couldn't tell the difference anymore. Had the evil from my dreams followed me at my heels? How had he found me here? How could this broken shell of a man barely able to carry the weight of his own sword. Be the burning terror which drove me to hide here. Demons of his own that he struggled to contain. And he was losing. As I watched, I became convinced that I was truly mad. The terror, the destruction, the evil I witnessed, how else could I explain them? Were these the demons from my dream, or were they born within the Wanderer? Why did I follow him? I don't know. Why do things happen as they do in dreams? All I know is that when he beckoned, I had to follow him. And from that moment, we traveled together east. Always into the east.
Set out with the dawn.
We traveled east, over the mountains and into the vast deserts of broken lands. As the days passed, my companion told me of himself, that he had once been a great warrior, and that a dark and secret burden now weighed heavily upon him. We traveled for an eternity across that arid wasteland. How long? I couldn't say. And always, a dark cloud seemed to follow us just over the horizon. Finally, the journey ended. We climbed the last bridge. There below us lay our destination. The shining jewel, Root Lane, with a great sea beyond. We made camp there last night. Perhaps it was the warm desert wind or the sound of the ocean, but for the first time in many weeks, I slept. However, the dreams return, but these were clearly not my own. I beheld the vision of a great man, the mage Talrasha.
Seek Marius. This is my brother. Sleep now. We set out with the dawn.
The next morning, we walked over the hill toward Lut Gulain. I had no idea then of the horrors that were in store for me there. My companion drew in the dank, cold air of the tomb. It seemed to strengthen him. I stood in the doorway between light and dark. What was left of my sanity implored me not to enter. But that voice was just a whisper now. As we worked our way down, deeper and deeper into the crypt, I began to see a change in my companion. He seemed to be gaining strength. I could hardly see in the gloom, but my companion seemed to know the way. We came at last to a great hall. It was then I realized my companion hadn't been gaining strength. He had been losing what was left of his humanity. He moved with demonic speed and then... appeared.
Stop! The beast contained herein shall not be set free, not even by you.
Thank you. Look what they've done to me. Release me. Help me.
Just ensured the doom of this world. You cannot even begin to imagine what you've set in motion this day. Go to the Temple of Light in the eastern city of Karast. There you will find the gate to hell opened before you. You must find the courage to step through that gate, Marius. Take the stone you hold to the Hellforge, where it will be destroyed. Now run. Take the stone and run!
Did I have? I ran.
Now, my young brother, the time has come to assume your true form.
I did as you told me, Tyriel. I found the Temple of the Zakharum. In the deepest recesses of the temple, I found a dog gathering. My companion, the Wanderer, Dalrasha, and a great evil who could only be the Lord of Hatred himself, Mephisto. I heard a voice then, like a thousand needles in my heart.
My brothers, at long last we stand reunited. The Infernal Gate has been prepared, and the time of our final victory is at hand. Let the way to hell be opened. And the evil that was once vanquished shall rise anew. Wrapped in the guise of man, shall he walk amongst the innocent, and terror shall consume they that dwell upon the earth. The skies shall rain fire, and the seas will become as blood. The righteous shall fall before the wicked, and all creation shall tremble before the burning standards of hell.
What I saw then was not meant for mortal eyes.
The gate stands ready. Time has come to assume your true form. Arise, Diablo. I will return, Diablo. Send forth your terror into hell.
Stone were destroyed in Hellforge. All except one. I heard later that he was defeated. And that the Soul Stone were destroyed in Hellforge. All except one.
Failed, dear Hill. I couldn't do as you asked. I couldn't enter that gate. Forgive me, dear Hill. Forgive me.
Marius, give me the stone. And all is forgiven. Give it to me, Marius.
Take it. I'm glad this is finally over, Tyrael. Look what the stone has done to me.
You haven't failed, old man. You've done exactly as you were meant to do. However, I am not the Archangel Tyrael.
Fail. No.
You have done well, man. Now I think you shall have your reward.
What have I done to deserve
this?
I shall take your position into consideration.
Thank you. Bail! The gates of Sesheron have stood for eons beyond remembrance, and you shall not breach them now.